Hello, I'm Tom Jensen from Danfoss PL1 product support team, and
today I will give you some important tips about the EVRC 15 to 20 normally closed servo diaphragm operated solenoid valves for reverse flow. This valve type is also called a bi-flow valve since it is designed both for flow in normal direction according to the arrow on the valve body, as you see here, and flow in opposite direction called reverse or backwards flow, as you see here. The EVRC bi-flow valve is used as a normal solenoid valve in the liquid line to control the flow to the expansion valve, and in addition, during defrosting, the condensed liquid can flow backwards through the EVRC valve when it is energized to open position. Here you see a principal diagram of such usage of an EVRC bi-flow valve as an alternative to traditional setup with a check valve, thereby reducing costs of parts and installation. Now, why do we need a special valve for this reverse flow? Well, for direct operator valves like EVR 2 to 3, as seen here, we do not. They can as standard be used for reverse flow. The problem with a normally closed servo diaphragm operator valve is that, despite the valve being opened by the coil power to allow flow backwards through the valve main orifice, then the reverse flow will also flow through the diaphragm orifice and build up pressure on top of the diaphragm, as you see here, and this way try to close the valve. The result is an unstable and fluttering diaphragm, which can cause diaphragm damage over time, in addition to unstable valve operation. The solution is to mount a check valve in the diaphragm orifice. So let us take apart an EVRC valve to look at such diaphragm design. Here you see this EVRC diaphragm design with built-in check valve. So only flow in normal direction can pass this orifice. This way, the reverse flow only passes through the main valve orifice from valve outlet to inlet without affecting the diaphragm. Now let us then shortly look at the effect on valve capacity for such diaphragm design. This capacity specified as kV value. As seen here, for EVRC 15, the kV value is lower than standard EVR 15, and in reverse flow direction, it is slightly lower than in normal direction. For EVRC 20, the kV value is significantly lower than standard EVR 20, but in reverse flow direction, it is actually higher than in normal direction. This strange behavior of EVRC 20 is caused by several complex factors acting simultaneously, mainly opening degree of diaphragm, lifting height of armature, and the area percentage of the check valve located in the orifice hole.
And if any questions related to this topic, please feel free to contact the PL1 product support team. Thanks for watching!